So the stress bag is 5 to 12 suggested. It's to get them to utilize coping skills when they're stressed out. Now, what we want, this is a practice. Initially, I always tell families that I'm giving them tools, but they have to practice and make the association and link. When I'm stressed out, I can do this. They can't initially do this. So these coping mechanisms, you're going to teach the child and practice. So we want the parent to practice when the child is not stressed out, so they understand they can do things and make that link for themselves that when I'm stressed out, I can do this. But initially, they're not going to be able to do it. They're going to have to practice it like we practice 2 + 2 = 4. We can't initially know that that's the answer. We have to practice it over and over and over. So feeling stressed, we're going to work on reducing that feeling. So it's a bag with handles, a stress ball, bubble wrap, these little balls that I have, I'll show you, paper to draw, Play-Doh, bubbles, and 8 index cards. I'm gonna let the child know that I'm gonna help them gain control of these stressful feelings, that we can do something with them, okay? There are things that you can do, and I'm gonna show you what they are today. So the first thing is a stress ball. You know, it's any type of ball. I got this for like $1, I think, at Target. Anything that they can utilize to let stress out of them and into something. So I'm teaching the child, let's pretend we're stressed out right now. What are we gonna do? Put the stress in the ball. So I'm gonna entice them, I'm gonna show them how to do it. I'm really stressed. Oh, I just wanna get that stress out of my body. Really teaching them, really showing them how to do this. Because if we don't, they're not gonna get it. So that's a stress ball. Adults use stress balls. It's proprioceptive input. It works on regulating the nervous system. They even have big stress balls. If a small one is not enough, get a larger one for them. Bubble wrap. Now, I think I showed this in the anger bag. You know, I teach kids that each one of these is like a cell in our body that's holding on to stress. There's a class downstairs, Mommy and Me class. I wonder what that is. Oh, the piano out there. You could tell them to stop, because they don't know it. Okay. There's a Mommy and Me class downstairs. This is a fantastic theater, just so you know. The Electric Lodge has so many events, dance, theater, classes, dance class, music. Really, if you want to join the mailing list, it's a great space. I don't know where you're coming from, but so many events here. So I teach them that in our body, because this is a great way to teach a child, stress hormones, cortisol. We've got, when we get stressed out and we flip our lids, stress, little pockets of stress like this, balls, get flooded in our bodies. And our bodies get filled with stress. It's called cortisol, stress hormone. So children need education. Teenagers, I'm always teaching teenagers flip your lid. I teach 5-year-olds flip your lid. So they understand when I get stressed out, I can't think. Oh, Mom, I'm flipping my lid. And it's funny because 5-year-olds will go around, Mommy, I'm flipping my lid. But they're communicating, I'm stressed. And they feel more in control, because when you're educated, you're educated. You're not ignorant. You're not hopeless. You're not confused. You have an understanding. Kids need an understanding of their stress related to their trauma. And we need to teach them that. So I let them know that this is all the stress that gets poured into your body. And each one of these is a stress hormone. So let's pop out, let's release and pop out all this stress. So I give them a big piece, I let them, they can walk on it, some kids roll on it, they can do it with their hands. Teenagers love this too. I do this as an icebreaker all the time. If I'm feeling like, you know, we need tools too as clinicians, because I'm a very, in this kind of work, you have to be intersubjective. You have to be really involved, connected. You're going to feel what your client's feeling. We need stress relievers too. I will do this with a client. If I'm feeling there's a lot of tension in the office, I'm going to do this too. Let's let off some steam. Let's pop some of our stress out. Let's release it together. So we'll both do it together. And it does. It's like an icebreaker. It just releases some tension in the air, and there's more regulation in the room. And then we can do more processing. So I think most of us know what this sounds like, but I'll just do a little bit. Because, yeah, do I have some stress? Yeah. There's stress on a daily basis, okay? Using our muscles, proprioceptive input, we're releasing, externalizing. We can use words while we're doing this. It's really a great experience, an interchange between the right brain and the left brain. I'm teaching how to let it go. Oh, okay, I feel better now. So that's the releasing stress in a fun way. So here's a few things, you know, and these are ideas. You know, these are not set in stone. Again, I said, okay, I'm going to teach a child how to externalize their stress, how to build coping mechanisms. So if you're feeling like there's something that you could utilize, please do so. You know, I developed these out of a way to just really think of techniques to provide them with coping mechanisms. So. The next one, Clacker Thinker, is something that I use to get a child to refocus. And they have these balls, I don't know where, they're like, you know that there's like this this machine that the balls hit each other, it's like a pendulum. I love that. Because that's the idea I was having, to have a child focus on something that's swinging, that they can try to see if they can get the balls to connect and have that experience. It's hard to do, but it can be fun. There we go. It has them refocus on something. If this doesn't work for the child, I'll have them incorporate something else that they can focus on, like one of these paddles where they hit the ball on the tennis, on the racket, something that they can do to transfer that energy, that stressful thinking onto something else. That's the idea. Then I was thinking of one of these where they do one of these muscle squeezing things. I think this was a dollar at Target too, just because I want them to get out that stress and put it in something. So that's what the Clacker Thinker idea was about. And mastering something, taking the time to refocus, transform that thinking into something that they can master, so that they feel a sense of control. Because stress can feel scary, overwhelming, panicky. So I want to give them something that they feel like they can master and feel good about, to transfer this cortisol into oxytocin and feel happier. So paper to draw is, again, drawing something that they're stressed about. And whatever they need to draw, write. Just yesterday I had a child who, she keeps cursing. And I said, okay, we're going to have a curse book. You know, she learned this behavior in one of her previous foster homes. There was a lot of profanity. And I, with her parents' permission, I said, would you allow her to have a book where she can put all this profanity? Parents said, sure, as long as, you know, it's put in this book. She has been using the book, and she does not get in trouble. She can say whatever curse word she wants, and she puts it right in the book. It's helping her. She knows where it goes now. She has a place to project it, and she's getting it out. I also did this with another child, And he actually didn't use the book. And I said, really, he's not using it? And the parent said, yeah, he's not cursing anymore. I said, wow, it's another form of containment, just like the bag. I know where it goes. It has a place now. There's a place I can put this. Because with a very stressed out brain, they don't know how to compartmentalize. It's chaotic. What are we doing with this bag? We're organizing the chaos. So a stress book can be anything. If they're using curse words, let it be a stress curse profanity book where they don't get in trouble. They can express whatever it is they need to put in this book, pictures or words. Play-Doh. Play-Doh is also another good stress reliever. As I had in the anger bag, the child takes out the Play-Doh, they rip it, they squish it, and they make it spaghetti, where it goes right through your fingers. And we do this over and over and over. Play-Doh is great for adults. I love the feel of Play-Doh. When you really utilize it, it helps relieve tension. So really teaching a child how to utilize these skills so they can be able to manage their stress. Because really, we can't rescue stress, we can't make it go away. We need to learn how to work through it. And that's what we're teaching kids. Because with children with trauma histories, the lifelong process in adoption is the lifelong process of managing all of these big feelings. They're going to be utilizing these coping skills their whole lives. So it's very important that they learn them now. Okay, so that's the Play-Doh rip squish. They repeat that 5 to 10 times. They can walk around the room, ripping, squishing, letting it out, standing up. They don't need to be sitting. We want them to utilize their whole body and be in this experience. Bubbles. So bubbles are also a stress reliever. Just like we did with the poppers, the child blows the bubbles, the parent can blow the bubbles, the child can pop the stress bubbles, or the child can blow the bubbles and the child can pop the bubbles. Again, getting that stress out of my body. Using language. I feel stressed. I don't want to feel stressed. Let me get the stress out of my body. Teaching them how to do that over and over and over. You can also have a child, this was a little small wand, but if you have a bigger bubble, they can blow bigger bubbles and imagine that the stress is in the bubble. Look at the bubble and pop it and make it go away. They can imagine they're a bubble, they're floating in the bubble, which can relieve some of that tension and create more of a sense of peacefulness, lightness. I'm not so heavy. Having them focus and glide with the bubble, watch the bubble until it pops. Refocusing, transferring that stress into something more positive for them. And stress busters. These are cards that are put into the bag that have things that they can read that tell them what to do. I just use a card, I write stress buster, and then I write what to do. Tighten my body for 5 seconds and let it go. Do it 3 more times. You know, when you tighten the body and you let it go, you actually let go of more tension because you don't want to feel that sensation of that tightness, that tension. Take 5 deep belly breaths. Teaching a child how to breathe, and one way that I've been doing that is I have the child lie on the ground, put a stuffed animal sitting on their belly, and they watch when they take a deep breath, the animal moves up, and when they let out the breath, the animal goes down. So they can have the understanding of the diaphragm. So it's really hard to teach kids how to do that, how to breathe. Bring air into your belly, watch the stuffed animal rise, and then let it out. So you're giving the stuffed animal a ride on your belly. Even with teenagers, I've done it. So they can understand and make the connection between the body and the mind and breathing. the body and breathing. Pretend I'm a statue in a museum for 10 seconds, then relax. It's pretty funny. Just freeze. That's another way of releasing tension. Because we want them to have this ragdoll effect. They just let it go. Freeze like a statue. Let it go. So they have this understanding of how to let go of tension in your body. Make your body like jelly. Stretch my body like a cat. I mean, these are things kids don't even understand. You hold tension in your body. I mean, sometimes I'm like, wow, I've been like holding tension in my lip. Sometimes I go, oh my goodness, I just like released my lip. And it's the strangest thing. I'm like, wow, I didn't know I was holding tension. We don't realize we're holding tension. So teaching kids how to stress, stretch, but we have to do it. You have to be the model. It's time to stretch. Sometimes if we're talking about something very heavy, you know, and it's difficult to talk about, go, oh, let's just all stretch right now. Let's just stretch. We're holding a lot of stress in our body. Let's make this easier for us. But we have to be direct, because this population, if you wait, you're going to be waiting forever. We have to feed them, nurture, educate. They can't do it for themselves. It's like I have families that go, I keep asking him what he's feeling. I go, he's not going to answer. You have to say, I see you're really, you have to tell him the experience. You have to communicate to him what you're experiencing about them. Check in with them and say, is that what you're feeling? Because you're looking really mad right now. Your face is scrunched up. Are you really mad right now? Oh, you're not. Oh, okay. Because you looked pretty mad when I said you couldn't have that cookie. You stamped your feet and you walked away. Oh, okay. What were you telling me with your body? So teaching kids to connect their emotions, their behavior, but we need to reflect it to them. We need to be direct, because they can't do it without our help. Okay, so those are stress busters, and here's a list of stress busters for you. I always ask a child, before I give them my suggestions, I'll say, you know, what do you think could help you when you're stressed? Because I'm giving you a lot of ideas here, but what do you think can help you? And we'll write it on the card. So again, with the bags, I say, let's pick three. I've showed you 16. Pick three that you think could help when you're stressed, and you're going to teach yourself how to do this, how to utilize this coping skill. They pick three things. They put it in the bag. It goes somewhere special in their room. It's not a toy, and it's something that they're going to practice every day. You don't have to be stressed to practice. You're teaching your brain, when I'm stressed, I can go do this. That's what I'm teaching a child. Because initially, they're not going to be able to do this. And that's the mistake that parents make. Oh, I've been using the stress bag. You know, whenever he's stressed, no, we need to practice it when he's not stressed. So his brain is trained. Oh, that's right. I'm going to go punch my ball. I'm going to go hit the tree with a stick. I'm going to let it out. That's what we want to teach them, how to project that stress and work through it.